Hey guys, what's up? This is GaLm and welcome to the Destiny Beta on the PlayStation 4. Now, if you watch my videos, then you know that I played the Destiny Alpha as a Titan. But in the Destiny Beta, I will be playing a Hunter. And hopefully, the experience will be a little bit different. I really enjoyed the Destiny Alpha, but it was kind of short on content, which is fine, right? It's the Alpha. I don't need to be able to play, like, the entire story or some shit. But hopefully, the Beta will have more content for me to be able to play, especially because I wouldn't want to replay the entire first area and then just be done again, right? So we'll see what kind of changes have been made. There isn't really like an official list from the get-go saying what's different from the Alpha and the Beta. There was like a leaked thing that was never really confirmed saying that there was like 4 story chapters or something. I don't know what that means. That could just be like 4 story missions or it could just be a lie. I'm not sure. But for now, I'm going to go ahead and make a character and let me go ahead and figure out what I want to make. Alrighty, so I think I am content with what I've got. There really wasn't anything added to the customization options. I couldn't really make any difference. I went through all of these to be like, all right, what's different? But I said, you know what? I might as well make a chick during the beta and play as that as my main character, since when the full game comes out, I'll be just playing a human male, because I'm generic like that. I'm just gonna play a human male. I don't like the Awoken. I don't like the way they looked. I was actually gonna make an Awoken female, but I was like, no, this doesn't work out. If anything, I would have made an Exo female, but they look weird too. So yeah, out of the lesser three, I was just like, eh, female, human, whatever. But yeah, I'm a little disappointed about the options. It'd be kind of cool if there were actual sliders. I like having full customization, even though this is a first-person game. The only places where we'll see my character's face would be at the tower, and in cutscenes. Actually, yeah, I guess, yeah, no. With cutscenes, you'd see your character's face a lot. Shit. Yeah, no, I wish there was a little bit more option. I'd like to see. Now, if I want to be someone who's being silly, with a crazy-looking face, I should have the option. If I want to have, like, a serious character where I'm like, alright, this is why they look the way they do, and this is why they choose the makeup that they do, whatever. I wish there would be a little bit more options. Although, you know, who knows? Maybe they'll add more as time goes on. Probably not hair. The hair looks pretty filled out, but face? Like, there's this whole set of empty slots over here, and in comparison to some other things, I think there's options for more, like even like different skin colors, lip colors, eye colors, all that kind of stuff. Just crazy things, you know. If it's an RPG, a game about customization and looking at how you want, they should include that. But now that we've gotten that out of the way, now I've gotten what I've had to say, let us get started.
Thank you. We called it the Traveler, and its arrival changed us forever. Great cities were built on Mars and Venus. Mercury became a garden world. Human lifespan tripled. It was a time of miracles. We stared out at the galaxy and knew that it was our destiny to walk in the light of other stars. But the Traveler had an enemy. A darkness which had hunted it for eons across the black gulfs of space. Centuries after our golden age began, this darkness found us. And that was the end of everything. But it was also a beginning.
Is it possible? There you are.
Wait. I was...
Guardian? Eyes up, Guardian.
I was just in some fucking dump in Russia?
You're alive.
Gah.
You don't know how long I've been looking for you. I'm a ghost. Actually, now I'm your ghost. And you, well, you've been dead a long time. So you're gonna see a lot of things you won't understand.
Yeah, like, you know, the things coming across the bridge to kill me?
This
great.
This is fallen territory. We aren't safe here. I have to get you to the city.
You have a gun?
Hold still. Don't worry, I'm still with you. We need to move. Fast.
What do you mean, move fast? I mean, it's obvious, but I would like to have a gun for safety, at least.
We won't survive long out in the open like this. Let's get inside the walls.
Are they coming? Are they gonna legitimately attack? I'm gonna run. You know, maybe I shouldn't just question these things. I gotta get out of here. Hey, birds. This is actually, okay, so now we can actually start from the beginning of our characters, so I suppose we actually start from level one. That's kind of cool. I don't know. See, cutscenes are what the alpha missed in terms of, making things a little bit better. Oh, Jesus. Yeah, alright, we gotta get out of here. Because in the alpha, we were just gonna drop in.
I need to find you a weapon before the Fallen find us.
Oh, now you want to give me a weapon, okay. Can you make light?
Right above us.
What? They're right above us. Let's just turn on our flashlight and go into the really dark place so it's really obvious. Oh, Jesus. Where we're heading. Yeah.
Hang tight. Fallen thrive in the dark. We won't. We need more light. I'll see what I can do.
Okay. Don't attract attention.
Another one of these hardened military systems, and a few centuries of entropy working against me.
Jesus Christ, there's so many of them in the dark.
Boy.
Here, I found a rifle. Grab it.
Really? What? Where? Oh! Well, that's convenient. Just chilling out here. So do you want me to just go ahead and fight things? Because,
hope you know how to use that thing.
Yeah, I'm dead, but I'm not dumb. Or rather, I've been dead, but I didn't become dumb.
Your eyes forward. Watch your tracker.
Oh, I like the sight on this thing. Well, let's investigate things. All right. We have the Kovostov S7GO2, an ancient weapon battered in war, but it still fires true. Perhaps it's been waiting for you. Don't make things so mystical. Oh, your gun that was sitting in the middle of a dump was waiting for you. And again, I guess the game is called Destiny. I just hope that not everything is all like, oh! Everything that's been laid out is for you to do, because you're special. I'm not the only guard out there. You know, these guys are actually a little bit more intimidating being introduced like this than when I just kind of randomly ran into them in the middle of the field.
There's more ahead. Keep it up.
Don't worry, I'll be fine. Ooh, wow, yeah, give me some ammo. Lots of it. Is this ammo or just a it's just a random light? I was like, oh, I gotta get more ammo! Not that I fully need it. See, these guys aren't that big of a threat. They're fallen. Ooh, what's this?
A loot cache. Let's see what's inside.
Yeah, sure, why not? What do we got? Oh, a sniper.
Calcutta LR2.
Engage and defeat the enemy at extreme range. The Calcutta series hails from a lineage that once guarded the city's wall built. I almost fucking kicked my computer. Okay. I didn't like the sniper rifle. Ooh.
Trip mines. Don't touch them.
Yeah, no, I wasn't intending on it. Anyways, what I was gonna say is I kinda liked the sniper rifle during the alpha, so we'll see what I end up trying to like in the in the beta. I'll probably just try to mix it up with assault rifles and maybe a fusion rifle, I'm not sure. I'll find what I need and use it then. You know, they kind of repurposed the wall from, like, a raid thing to a introduction of a lot of things! So I'm a little worried about what's gonna end up happening as we clear this room. Are there more? Of course there are more. There are always gonna be more. Oh, I don't even have my double jump yet. That makes me kind of sad. Jeez.
I have a tighter hold on this place than I thought. Just a little bit further. Let's hope there's something left out there.
Yeah, I think I know what's going to happen here. We're gonna go out and be like, whoa, look at the world. Doesn't it look amazingly destroyed? And then we'll get contacted by someone. That's just kind of what I figure.
This was an old cosmodrome. There's got to be something we can fly out of here.
You're not suggesting I use one of those old shuttles, right? I mean, that's kind of designed to go straight up. Uh-oh. Oh, no. Oh,
incoming.
No. What, really? For me? Little tiny me, you're gonna call in a big ship? What the fuck?
Fallen ships this close to the surface? Move!
Okay, yeah, no, I'm making a move. There's a dead devil walker there. I'm gonna stay back, you know? I have to fight my way through this. What the? Oh, I got hit by the fucking ship's cannon. Because they're assholes like that. Oh, I wish there was penetration with the sniper. I would have gotten quite a lot of kills right there. I don't even have to aim at their heads at this point. There's level one. I shoot them and they die. Actually, I guess that's kind of the end goal of everything. I shoot them and they die. But I just mean to say they die in one shot. But it is a sniper rifle, so what else do I expect? Oh! I figured there was something left over the hill! Who knows, maybe the Fallen have just been waking up too? Uh-oh. So these guys, for the last, like, couple centuries, they've just been kind of chilling out, and they're like, uh-oh. Humans are coming back! Guess we should send a couple of guys out there. And now we're here. Let's see, what can I get at level 2? Hold up. Oh! My grenades. Blade Dancer. Oh, shit. I guess once I'm level 15, I'll be able to try this out. I hope that we can get to level 15, because that would be kind of cool, to go and try out this Blade Dancer thing. It sounds like it could be useful. But for now, I'm just shooting things.
Signs of an old jump ship. Could be our ticket out of here.
Alright, well, is it going to be inside this particular facility, or is it going to be beyond the wall? Because that's going to be a pretty important info. Okay, I'm just going to shoot these guys like this. And then, Granada! Holy shit. It still takes a while for the grenade to recharge.
There's a ship. Clear him out.
Hey, found a devil guy. He's got. That's convenient. Look at it, just kind of hanging out. Did it fall in like that? Or was it always hanging here? These are the questions I wish to know the answers to. But we don't really need them. Sir, someone's behind the pillar. I got him.
All right, let me see if I can get us out of here.
I'd be kind of impressed. It does look like it's connected to stuff, so no, it's been here.
It's been here a while. Hasn't made a jump in centuries. We're lucky the Fallen haven't completely picked it clean.
Will it fly?
I can make it work. Okay, it's not going to break orbit. It just might get us to the city. Now, about that transman.
Do you want me to fight this giant dude?
Bringing you in.
Oh, all right.
We can come back for them when you're ready. Let's get you home.
I kind of care more about the ships now. That was kind of a badass startup sequence. So like I said, it's definitely the alpha was missing cutscenes to make this game actually, like, kind of enjoyable. I just like really good cutscenes and awesome music and, like, dialogue and talking and stuff. Although we'll see how much our character ends up happening as they go about their missions and stuff like that. You know, I'm really glad the giant alien ball is still our friend after all this time.
Welcome to the last safe city on Earth. The only place the Traveler can still protect. It took centuries to build. Now, we're counting every day it stands. And this tower is where the Guardians live.
Scheduled task added to queue. Priority 3.
Huh. You know, I did not know that the back of my head was shaved. Okay, that's another point off of the customization of the character creator. I can't even see the back of my head, so I didn't know I had a shaved head. So it's just like, here's the front. You're like, oh, cool, that looks nice. She's got short hair, works out. Whatever. Small problem. Although I think that they need to work on the seamlessness of the cutscene to this, because there was like a 30-second load time between the cutscene ending and me actually being able to, like, come in. And then, not only that, I spawned into the world, which is okay when we teleport here, but not when I'm coming out of a cutscene where I'm already standing there. That, minor gripes, but I'm just saying it out is. Alright, welcome, Hunter. Kate Six, the mentor of new hunters arriving in the tower, can help you with equipment. Should I talk to the postmaster? They have something on them. Welcome! Message from Bungie. Thank you for helping us test Destiny. This is our beta test, to make sure everything holds up under heavy load. We couldn't do it without you. Neat. They gave me 500 little... Alright, they gave me 500 monies for that. What's the name of the money again? It is Glimmer. Okay, I forgot the name. I'm like, something. Is there anyone else that wants to be introduced to me at this time? Not so much? Alright. Maybe we can actually have a conversation with the hunter guy. The tutorial dude who helps me out. Because last time I just kind of went there, gave him my quest, and I was like, alright! Cool being here, dude.
Do warlocks interest you?
They actually do. But, I'm a hunter. I'm not about that life. Welcome, Guardian. No, he's just gonna give me stuff.
You're gonna love this. Try it out.
Level 4? He's got level... Oh, that's level 8? Shit. I was gonna say, he's got a green on him already, so that's kinda cool. Vanguard rank 2. Ooh. Oh shit, he's gonna restock his thing in 10 seconds. No! What if I want some of these? I just wanna see the stock refresh at this point, actually. The green's gone. That's actually kind of disappointing. I don't know, man. You started off strong, but now it just seems like we're going through the whole rounds of tutorials again. Alrighty, well, we are back in orbit. I just did a jump cut because I could see where that was going. So they didn't have any cutscenes where we're talking with the characters and getting to know them or something, so I don't care about them as much. They're just things I sell and buy stuff from. But maybe we'll be able to do another mission. Let's see. Return to the Fallen Territory and hunt for parts to restore your ship's ability for interplanetary travel. Ah, okay, here we go.
There's so little left out here. We were lucky to even find this ship. A Guardian can't do much to protect the city without one. But it needs a warp drive if we ever hope to fight beyond Earth. And that Cosmodrome is the only place I know where we might still find one. We survived the Fallen once. We can do it again.
I think that instead of surviving, I think we'll just kick their ass. That sounds, like we have a lot more confidence in ourselves. We can survive them again. No. We're gonna annihilate them. And take what we need.
The Guardian ship was recently shot down here. If the Fallen haven't gotten to it, there might be parts we can salvage.
Alright, well, where am I going to? Is it right across the way? Do I have a little... Oh, I don't have my speed bike at the moment. Maybe I kind of missed the Alpha starting us off with a speed bike and... jump ship and everything. Oh well. Oh, right. I chose an auto rifle this time. versus accidentally choosing a pulse rifle, because, yeah, no, I want to try out auto rifles and use them effectively, even though damage per second wise, it probably would be better if I used a hand cannon or a pulse rifle or a scout rifle, but we can change depending on what's available, you know? If I find a green weapon that's really good, that's all I'll need, right? But is that what I gotta go? Ah. So is this blinking thing a warp drive? Or no, I think it's just a beacon. Ghost? Oh, it didn't fully deploy. It's still not fully deploying. Come on, Ghost, I believe in you. You gotta investigate the ship. So that way we can get the warp drive and be able to explore all the other planets, like Mars and stuff. I didn't even know that Mars was colonized. I knew it was Venus and Mars, but not Mercury, is what I wanted to say.
The ship's avionics are completely catatonic, but I can call their last transmission.
I didn't understand any of that.
To restore an information hub here. Down in the tunnels below. We should check it out.
What do you mean, tunnels below? Listen, Ghosty. The last time I went into those tunnels, bad shit happened. I got hurt. And I probably died a few times. But I'll go down. I'm sure there's not level 20 dudes in there now. Although it is interesting enough that they adjusted Peter Dinklage's lines to sound more robotic. Which, you know, I didn't find it an issue before, but a couple of people did complain in the comments like, oh my god, it just sounds like he's talking, I didn't even know he was the robot. And I guess I could see where you're coming from with that. I mean, you hop into the game and you just hear Peter Dinklage talk, you're like, oh, I guess that's me. No, he's the robot. But if you're an exo, I guess that's still gonna kind of confuse you until you're watching the cutscenes and you're all like, oh, well, my character's talking versus his character. Bam. Jesus, how many of them are there? Holy shit! If only my grenades charged faster, they'd be like, oh no, a group of enemies dead. Alright, I think we're good. We got most of them, if not all of them. Although, I'm wondering how far he wants me to go down here. Because to be fair, yeah, okay, that's what I figured. There's a little console in here. And I was wondering whether or not we were going to activate it or go further down. Here you go.
What we really need to find is a warp drive, so we can jump to any planet or moon. Our only hope is where we found our ship. We have to go back.
Aww. Alright, I can do that. But first I have to investigate things. Alright, I see some red pings on my radar. And I'm wondering if they're gonna be down here again. Yeah, I'm leaving. Alright, we got the level 20 things. Oh, jeez. Speaking of level 20, I think it's been confirmed that the level cap is 20. Or rather, I should say, the XP level cap is level 20. It's kind of like pure speculation, watched a couple of videos, saw some screenshots. But from what it looks like, I think we cap out at level 20, and then after level 20, the way we level up is by getting better gear that has a point system called light motes. Or not light motes, light motes are the... Was it light motes? I'm not sure. Like, if we ever get to level 20, I'll be able to fully explain it. But yeah, no. So technically, at the end of the alpha, we were right. Level cap's 20, and then there's a little bit more beyond that. So that's kind of neat. I do like the idea of that, because after level 20, rather than being all like, oh, I gotta level up and worry about being restricted by levels. No, instead it's gonna be like, oh, now I'll just find any gear and try to scale it to that. And then all the fights afterwards and raids and things like that are also going to be scaled for our skills rather than just our levels. So we can't just be like, oh, I'll just level up 3 or 4 more times and be good. No, no, you're stuck at level 20. You have to be good or lose. I like the sound of that. It's very kind of Diablo-esque, but at the same time, not really. Diablo, you level up a shitload. Let's no-scope him! Yes! I almost didn't no-scope him. Okay. He was gonna throw a little tiny grenade. That's cute. So, let's see what we got in our inventory. I got a little helmet. And it's level 3. People are getting mad at me whenever I didn't check my inventory, like, immediately, but a large amount of the time, the shit that we get is above our level, or it's locked off until we head back to the tower. So that's how I wasn't really checking them out. Because when you get greens or blues or any other type of color item, you have to get it decoded. And after a certain level, all you're really finding is, like,
scanning
greens and stuff.
Drive. Bad news. It's already in fallen hands.
That's alright, I can find it. Do they just have it here, or do they actually run away?
I hope you're ready for this.
Respawning restricted. If you die in a darkness zone, you'll be returned to the start of it. Oh. So that's what it means, right? I didn't know that. Like, that wasn't explained ever. Before, and it's just like, you're entering a darkness zone, I didn't know what the fuck that meant. I guess if I have to consider the fact that if I die, I die. Partially, it might be bad. But I'm not worried about death. Not this time, at least. Oh, yeah, that guy! I'm gonna throw a grenade and burn him up a little bit. He is fucking huge! But it's alright, because I had my sniper rifle and glorious amounts of headshots. Oh. Alright, see, we got an encrypted engram already. But we're fine.
You just killed an Archon. This could cripple the Fallen. And we got a warp drive. I have to get you to the speaker.